I'll let you know if I can catch it. Alright, so we've picked it up on a sonar. And we're going to have to go way faster if we want to catch this mother. In fact, I'm going to try to go parallel with him for right now. And hopefully get a... Holy God, he's going... No, I forgot, I'm submerged. Surface, I need to get ahead of this guy. There we go. There we go, that's a good way to get ahead of him. Keep him on sonar, and crank up the speed. Okay, so now we're going to go down to standard, and I want you to intercept him right about here. Because he's been going sort of like this, I think. And we'll put down a mile marker so we know when we'll be in range. Oh boy. Where did he go? I lost him. I might have gone too far ahead, but I don't know. Oh, there he is. So my marker's wrong. Looks like he's... Oh man, I need to plot him. Damn it. Alright, we'll continue ahead here. I'm actually gonna... Do we get another one, or is it the same one? Alright, so... We should have another plot on him here. Alright, looks like he's going... I just had his course plotted wrong. I had it wrongly! So let's put down another mile marker. And boy. We got a ways to go. But... Whoopsie. Give me my marker. No, what? Oh, crap. I'm screwing this all up. Here we go. Yes, Exo. Turn us the fuck around. Get us to right there. Quickly. If he gets any closer, I'm gonna periscope it. I'm actually gonna periscope already. We're so close, it doesn't matter. Hopefully he'll just follow along that course. So let's go ahead and slow down to 1/3. And I'm gonna come to a stop. And we'll see if I got my course right. And I didn't. I may shoot him with my rear torpedoes here, because it looks like I got my course wrong again. Either that or he turned, which is possible. And considering the drastic nature of the change here, I'm going to go ahead and say he turned and shifted or something. Alright, so there. That's our new marker, and that puts us... Too far, just barely too far away. Alright, so I'm gonna back it up a, oh boy. Oh shit, that's not backwards. My bad. Oh god! What am I doing here? My guy was still on autopilot, so... Turn me left, I think, is where we want to turn. Left. I said left. Oh well, I guess we are gonna go straight at him. Forward torpedo tubes, if we need them. Alright, that was silly, but here we are within range, theoretically. I'd like to be closer, obviously. Who wouldn't? Alright, I'm going to call it right there. We'll keep going ahead 1/3. Okay, so, let's get our gear up. Clear our previous data. And put it to reverse, stop, and then raise the scope. Although, because it's at night, this caution probably isn't even necessary. I'm going to open up my tubes. Tubes 1 and 2 only. And let's raise it up and see if we can spot us a boat. Should be right about here. Oh, I guess it's not nighttime. Hello, Dolly. That looks like another big one. Alright. No. Large old split. No, he's got double. Large modern composite. Let's take a look at the angle. Yeah, that looks like him. I think that's him. Because look at that. That's exactly that. Alright. Mark it down. Let's go ahead and get his... bearing first. It's going to be sort of like that, I think. That might be a little too extreme. Like that. Range will be thusly. thusly. And please tell me you can estimate his speed. 1 knot. Something tells me you are wrong. Let me check with my sonar guy. Range, do you have his speed? Bearing. I'll send range and bearing in. That's not right, unless it is. No, our sonar guy's stupid again. What are you doing? Why does he have me like that? What? No, it's like that. Okay, that's not quite right either. Oh my god, I think something got screwed up here. Oh, fucking hell. I should not have... What are we doing here? Why is everything spinning? No, stop it. Okay, stop. Don't. No. Fuck you. Follow the nearest contact. Range is 140. Is that what we have in here? I don't know. I think we might have just screwed up big time. Because, there we go, 6 knots. That looks good. Okay. Fire. Alright, and recalculate his range. Make sure the position's good. Can I get another speed check? Good. Fire. Alright. Following that, standard speed, surface the boat, and we'll take a look and see how our... This is mostly torpedo practice. I don't even need to shoot torpedoes at this guy. I just want to check my targeting abilities. Also, it's a little bit faster than shooting them with my gun. We've got him. It would have been nice to use my rear torpedoes on an easy target like this. This one might not hit. Looks like I got my range wrong a little bit. I'm really glad the fucking targeting system decided to stop freaking out. Regardless, get on that gun and shoot him. Yeah, we're gonna hit him with the one right in his rear. Plink. Actually, yeah, there we go. That one was good. The other one will probably miss now because we let him know we were here. The other one was going way slower, so it'll probably go... He's going to change course, and the other one will probably miss him. Or not! You are having a bad day. Oh, you're having a really bad day, homie. I'm sorry. Did I do that? Oopsie. Big ol' hole in his ass. Let's just go watch the fireworks. Let's see here. There's a big torpedo hole. There's another big hole. I guess this one didn't leave a big hole in them. Sometimes you'll get really big holes from the torpedoes. Sometimes, usually, when you get those water damage ones, I've seen them blow holes straight through to the other side. The damage modeling in this is actually really good. You can hit them if there are spots on here. I don't know where they are. Usually, I find that they're directly under the smokestack, right around here. Where you can hit their fuel or ammo reserves, or something like that. Either way, this is our guy. He's listing pretty heavy. I'll watch it from the bow. I'm gonna go ahead and turn with him, so rudder, yes, sir. We can carry on watching from here. Plink. No supplies for you, Japan. I'm so sorry. Your soldiers on the front line will not be receiving their daily supply of tentacle porn and, and Pokemon Game Boy cartridges that are on this ship. So sorry. My gunner's pretty good. He hasn't missed a single shot, and they've all been below the waterline. That one was pushing it. Although we are turning in his defense. What is that? What the hell is that? Smoke on the water, guys. Alright, enemy unit destroyed. So I'll go ahead and send in my report. Still haven't been awarded the completion for patrolling the Luzon Strait, but I'm okay with that. Considering we've been rewarded with that. Kaboom. And there's all their cargo floating to the surface. All those Game Boy cartridges and boxes of used panties and Japanese people are weird. Alright, so another target in the Luzon Strait. I want to make sure, I mean, I'm pretty sure we're like within the Luzon Strait. I don't know what the range of this marker is, though. I hope we're not out of it. Alright, so let's go ahead and Replotsky, our course ski. Where's our next marker? Here it is. Let's go head up here. I'm gonna go ahead and delete all of these, because I want to stay up a little further. Around this marker as much as possible. I don't want to fluff it up and not get my marker marked. Okay, so we've returned to course. Everything went well there. I'm gonna put my guys in the torpedo room so that they can reload those. Get to work in there! Load them faster! Look, it's like really, really, really slow sex. Inserting, inserting, inserting. Everybody's getting lots of good experience. The top rows are all sleeping. Hopefully my radar men will be awake by morning. That'd be nice, because the airplanes are gonna kill me. I know they are. Alright, tube one's ready, tube two's ready. Alright, you guys get the rest of the night off. Have fun storming your bunk. Got a radio report of an enemy task force. All the way up there. Okay, so we're back on patrol, and I'll be back when stuff happens. Fuck! Guess who left his fucking periscope up again? I don't think they've seen me. I don't know, they didn't turn towards me, or this might just be an old update. Eh, boy. I'm gonna go ahead and turn, just in case they decide to drop some bombs on us. Okay. Are we good? Is everybody gonna be okay? Are we gonna be fine? Whoa, everybody disappeared. Where'd everybody go? Okay, there you are. I think we're good. Yeah, let's go ahead and return to course. I do that all the time. I leave my periscope up. Because I'm a big derp. So, you know, what are you gonna do? Okie dokie, we've got a contact of a merchant ship. I had no warning of this, we just sort of patrolled right into it, which is the way it's supposed to go. So let's see where he's headed. It said closing, but, you know, you never know. It is closing. So, yeah. Okay, whoa, stop. Hell, we might be on a fucking intercept course already. Okay, let's put down some more markers. This could be just a stumbling into payday right here. That's enough to get a good course. All these other courses don't interfere with it. Alright, so we can guesstimate. Should come across us right about here. And a mile out would be... Whoa! What do you know? I'll be damned. Alright, let's, just reposition ourselves just a smidgey smooge. Now our only problem here is waiting. Cool thing is that waiting at periscope depth is really easy. So I have no reason not to wait at periscope depth. So we'll just wait for him to come across us, and ooh, he might go a little wide. Let me check his range again. If he comes out here, that'll be out of range. So let's go ahead and periscoot ourselves up, because I think he's further away than I thought. As usual, I got my courses plotted wrong, but it looks like he's going to be coming across like this-ish. And a mile marker here would be, we are in range, theoretically. Again, theoretically. So we'll hit the brakes. And coast to a stop, hopefully ridiculously close to him. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to crank it right and turn around and see if I can nail him with a rear torpedo shot. Because we've used a bunch of our forward torpedoes. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull everybody to battle stations, because we're about to have one. You know. Alright, alright, alright. And there we go. Parallel parking in a submarine. You bet your ass. Oh man, we're gonna be really close to this guy. Alright. Stop, straighten out. I said stop. Did he stop? Oh, fucking hell! We just lost contact with him for some reason. Okay. So go right. And give me a little bit of speed forward. Oh my god, what? Is he just hauling ass, or what's going on here? It's going to be a rough shot with the rear torpedoes. Alright, so we're going to open up 5 and 6. Where are you at, buddy? Ooh, I've not seen you before, and you are kind of hauling ass, aren't you? Damn. Okay, so he's got a tilted stack. That's our guy. Medium composite European. Okay. Clear our old marker. Oops. And we'll put him thereabouts. No, he's... I don't know. I have no idea what to put in here. I might be able to... Okay, he's going 2 knots. I'm going to have my sonarman send him a bearing, because I don't know what it is. There we go. Alright, so we sent him in a bearing, and I'll put in a range one more time. And I don't know if this is going to actually be a calculable 8 knots fire. I don't know. I'm not really experienced with firing rear torpedoes. That looks good, actually. That looks like a good shot. Okay, so let's go ahead and have ourselves another one. Can't re-guesstimate his speed, but we can re-guesstimate his range. I'm going to bring myself to a stop. And let's put this torpedo on contact high speed. Can we get a new speed on him? Nope. But we can get a new range there. And assuming he's going the same speed, we'll just fire anyway. High-speed torpedoes will go fast. Hopefully, I mean, if you do it right, you can hit him at the same time. I didn't, obviously. And in fact, I'm going to miss him twice. I think he's turning. Because look, my marker's right on. What I can do, though, is put a spread on it and assume that he's going to turn. So, I'm going to do a little fun with manual targeting here. Alright, open 6. We got extra tubes here, so if you've got a bit of information, you can put a manual spin on it. And after that, what we're going to do is turn ourselves around and whether we hit him or not. And I don't think we are. Oh! Got him! One of those got him with the... So let's surface it. Excellent. I'm happy we got him with one of those. Sometimes that's what you gotta do. You gotta put a manual spread on it. Although it's a really good idea to put it back to zero when you're done. Because if you don't... Durr. Okay. There we go. Alright, so... Where are you at, buddy? Where did you go? Torpedo impact. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Oh, man, we hit him again! I'll be damned! I didn't think we were gonna hit him a second time. Ooh, he's got a gun, though. That's not good.
Yes, sir. Ahead, slow.
I think we should be able to take him down with 2 torpedo impacts, though, and guns on him. Yeah, I don't think he'll do any damage to us, or he'll probably do a little. He might hit us. Where are you shooting? Let's take a look at our little naval engagement here. From a distance. Yeah, he's not a happy man. I'm pretty surprised we hit him with 2 of those. Did you hit me? Oh, God. Shit. Yeah, look at that. He blew a hole right in the fucking side of our ship. Okay. Flank speed. Son of a bitch. See, you can't... Oh, look at that. You can't discount these guys. Alright. Fuck. Fuck. I saw somebody in here that had a repair skill. You. You're the leading the damage control team. Actually, that wasn't the guy I chose, but whatever. Yeah, I'd like you guys to start fixing. I usually grab... It looks like our forward torpedo room got smashed, which is swell. So, man, you guys are horrible. Wow, why are you guys all picking the wrong thing? Okay, enemy unit destroyed, though. Down he goes. But we still have to deal with the consequences here. So I'll have you return to course. And slow down. And we gotta get this stuff fixed before morning. Because if we don't, we won't be able to dive and the planes will war garble. They will destroy our faces. Who's left here? Okay, no repair, no repair. Alright, you've got some repair skills. You'll be the leader of repairinators. Get back in there, you suck. Okay, repair. Oh man, this is so weird. I click here and I drag, and by the time I get over here, it picks up like this guy. Okay. Alright, that ought to be enough for now. You can have a dedicated damage control team, but I like to leave a little space. So we're not too crowded, you know? I don't know if there's any reason to do that. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to save the game, not because we're damaged. This is nothing serious at all. We don't even have flooding. They'll get this fixed in no time. But I'm going to save the game because it's known to be crashy after Sinky Shippy. So I'll name it... if it'll let me... Jeff1, and thank you to the good sir who notified me that I should save the replay, because that gives me... It's like a backup of your save, too. So it's like doubling your chances of being able to recover a save. Alright, and now we just have to wait for the repairs to kick in, so... I'm gonna go ahead and... I think I already told him to return to course. Pressure hull intact and batteries repaired. See, it didn't take any time at all. So we're gonna secure from battle stations. Back to 100%, although we still have a big hole in our ship. You can't fix that while at sea. We just basically sealed off part of it. And a bunch of our guys were injured here. Looks like they're recovering well, though. He's 100% health, but he's fatigued. 98% health. Yeah, they just got a little dings. They're scratched. They'll be fine. Alright, so everybody get back to your stations. You semen, you. And... my forward torpedo room's a little more important, so I'm gonna put the injured guys in the rear torpedo room. So they don't have as much to do. Alright, yeah. I guess go ahead and reload my torpedo. I know, I put all the injured guys in there, and I'm like, you injured fuckers, get to work, load my torpedo tubes! Who knows, maybe they'll get it done eventually, I don't know. I'm not in any real hurry. Yeah, this is me recording. Because I didn't unmute my microphone. It's only about 10 minutes though, so it's not so bad. So I'm going to try to guide you through and explain what I'm doing here. I'm using my pencil. I'm putting markers down, because we've got contacts. Some of them are warships, some of them are not. It looks like a convoy. And... I think I'm deciding right now whether or not it would be a good idea to go play Convoy Funsies. Considering I've already sunk a bunch of ships. I did report to contact. I sent that contact information out and sent in a report of my current situation. Hoping that they would be like, you've done enough, soldier. You can go home. Whoa. It is not to be. Spoiler warning, I guess. Because I'm from the future and I know what happens. They didn't send me home right away. I'm going to be out here for a while. One thing that's difficult about doing post-commentary, particularly over my videos, is that, as I'm sure you are all very familiar with, it can be difficult to explain what I'm doing when I'm doing it. Like right there, I just realized I had my periscope up. Even though I was underwater, I forgot, and so I actually spotted that probably destroyer that was coming around there. It's just a screen on the edge of a convoy. No big deal. Just a random bit of happenstance. So, I think I'm just checking in with the dudes here. And that guy's got no eyeballs right now. Which is creepy as fucking hell. I don't even know how he's looking at the map. He's got no eyes. Let's be honest here. Why are you even trying? At least... He has no eyes with which to stare at my ass for all of eternity. What a way to go, man. Can you imagine that? Spending the last days, months, weeks of your life staring at someone's ass. Oh, horrible. So I put it in silent running there, because I was all like, oh my god, they're going to kill me. And they are kind of hunting me down. As you can see, they're going off of their course, and I'm having to evade. Just checking the range on them to see how far away they are. At around 5 nautical miles, there's no way they could catch me with their sonar. And I could probably surface at this point in the night and be safe, but I was pretty paranoid here. Starting to get a little worried about the possibility of making it home. So there we go. We are on our way. With a quickness, too. Dodging planes and shit. I don't know what's happening here. Oh yeah, there's a plane. And I'm probably gonna dive. I'm probably right now complaining about planes and saying about how I'm gonna skip ahead or something. Oh, there we go, I skipped ahead. And we've got a contact update on a merchant ship. Or I suppose it... I imagine it's a merchant. So we're gonna plot a course to intercept it and hopefully destroy-nate it. Because that's what we do here. We destroy-nate stuff. So, changing course, trying to figure out where he's going to come from so that I can intercept. This is one of my most favorite parts of a Silent Hunter series. Playing with map tools. I just muted my microphone right there. I think what happens is that it lays against my leg and brushes up against the side of my desk and mutes itself. Hell, I don't know. Oh, in perfect timing, we get a couple of plane escorts to come by. And then a third one comes by, because they're all like, oh my god, you're going to sink your ship. Why don't we come and hang out and ruin your fun? So I go all periscope depth right there. Which is annoying, because I have to recalculate my course, because it's going to take me longer to get there underwater. I can only travel 4 knots at 2/3 ahead when I'm below the surface. But plenty of time, because this guy is going slow as balls. And as of right about now, we should be within firing range, unless I've got my calculations wrong, and I'm pretty sure I usually do. So I think I decided here to try and recalculate his course, although it looks to be like he's on the same course I had plotted. I don't trust myself, though. Would you trust me? I mean, really? No. It's a horrible idea. You know what I do. This is why we can't have nice things. Alright, so it looks like I've got myself laid up in a little trap here. I'm just checking my levels of stuff to see if I've got enough juice to lay in wait. And I want to be about... That's pretty far out, so I think I decided to scoot forward a bit, because 0.5 nautical miles is a good place to get a shot off. Anything closer and you'll risk screwing up your calculations, possibly losing sonar contact, something like that. And anything further away and you'll be out of range. So, that's the theory. I don't know what I'm doing here, or what I would be saying. I'm sure I'm saying something really important. Magical, even. Ah. This is where I put my periscope up and decide that I'm going to shoot a torpedo at this fool. You fool! I will shoot you with the torpedo. I love this part of the identification of enemy ships. That one looks like it's got a straight stack and square beams. That looks like it. Yeah, that's it. You can see by the exhaust pipes. That actually kind of doesn't look like it. Yeah, I think I decided that wasn't it. That's not it either. That is it. Coastal composite freighter. Not real big, but worth spending a couple torpedoes on. You know, a gift from the U.S. Navy. From me to them. So... Obviously, feeding data into our computer manually. as usual, our crew gets the speed estimation way fucking wrong. It's going 1 knot or 40 knots, somewhere between there. I'm not sure. Although, I mean, it's moving really slow, so I guess they couldn't have been, you know, too wrong. I have my rear torpedo selected here, so I'm a little confused as to why... Okay, there we go. Brain turn on! Brain screen, turn on. Still thinking it's going 1 kilometer per hour. I'm trying to figure out why. I think I actually have the bearing wrong. This is probably why. So there we go. We got that, and one fish in the water. Opening up tube 2. Gonna give it a little bit of a weight and fire that baby off. I think I do, anyway. I don't know. I could be wrong. Maybe I don't. I think I tried to go for high speed on this one so I could get them to contact at the same time, if possible. Assuming that he's going the same speed, recalculating the distance, marking in the bearing, and plunk, fishies in the water. Not sure exactly what that little white X means, but I think I must have got his range and bearing wrong. Yeah, I did get his bearing wrong, because he's... Nope. Yep. Nope. No. No, 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 me. There we go. There. Good job, me. Not that it matters. You're not really going to spend 3 torpedoes on a fucking freighter, are you? No. No, me. I'm not. I do believe that, yes, that one is definitely a hit. Plunk right in the nose, that one. Which is a good spot. The second one missed, although it looked like it should have hit him. I don't know how it missed. It must have gone under him. But I think I decided that I was going to go ahead and surface here because, I mean, look at him. What's he going to do? He is obviously sinking. His engine is lifted out of the water. He is sinking. It's not like he's going to fight back. Look at that. The front of his ship is completely submerged. Here's what's funny. You can see in the top there, it'll say when the ship is destroyed. That's when they abandon ship. That's when the crew has decided, okay, this sucker's going down. He still has not abandoned ship. I had to go and look at this for myself. The captain of this ship is just like, no, it's fine. We can do it. The engine is not in the water. I mean, look. The whole fucking ship is underwater. He's going to wait for the fucking water to get to knee height in the thing before he deploys the escape ship. Look at him, he still has an abandoned ship. There we go. Yeah, he waited to get about chest high in the captain's cabin before he decided that the ship was sinking. Way to go, buddy. Way to go. So I think it's going to end here, because I think we finished commentary stoppage. But, yeah. I hope I did alright covering up for myself. And I hope you guys enjoy the rest of this, because there's a big hole in my ship. I forgot about that. Not so intimidating with a big hole in my ship. And I just realized I had my fucking microphone muted that whole time. I don't know why that happens. I think it's because the cord is sitting on my leg, and I don't know, whatever. I'll record post-commentary over that, maybe, if I have to. Because that was kind of awesome. I don't know how long it had been muted for. Probably forever. Here we are. Still making that money.